In a few hours, President Trump will speak to the nation about the mass shootings this weekend that left 29 people dead over a span of just 13 hours. The president this morning calling for background checks legislation and that legislation be married to immigration reform. He has not yet used the term white nationalist terror. Joining me now is Democratic presidential candidate Congressman Tim Ryan of Ohio. He has suspended his campaign to return to his home state. Congressman, we appreciate you taking some time for us this morning. I know you've heard what the president had to say, likely seen that tweet that he put out asking for a coupling of both this expanded background checks and immigration reform. What's your take on that?
That's a joke. That's an absolute freaking joke that he's going to tie this to the most polarizing issue happening in the United States today around immigration reform. This is very clear cut here. There are people that are getting access to guns that shouldn't be, and the guns are high powered. The magazines hold too many bullets, and they're coming to places like Dayton and El Paso, Walmarts, entertainment districts, churches like Mother Emanuel AME in South Carolina, and they're killing American citizens. Mitch McConnell needs to get off his ass and do something. People are getting killed in the streets in America, and nobody's acting, nobody. There's a bottleneck in the United States Senate. The House has sent a comprehensive background check bill that's supported by 80 to 90% of the American people. What the hell are we doing in the United States of America? I'm telling you, people are fed up. We were here in Dayton last night. There were tears and there was rage. And people in Washington, D.C., and the state capitals need to get their act together and pass some legislation that 80 to 90% of the American people support. For the president of the United States, in the midst of this tragedy, both in the southernmost part of this country and in the northern part of this country, in the last 24 hours, lose 29 people, and he's going to tie this to immigration reform? That's a joke.
What are you hearing in terms of a response? You have been very clear since this happened, first expressing your condolences and your anger and how upset you were when it happened in El Paso. Hours later in your home state there in Dayton, I know you've made the call multiple times. You just did it here on our air for lawmakers to come back. You want Mitch McConnell to call the Senate back. Are you calling your Republican colleagues across the aisle, folks that you know both in the House and in the Senate, and saying, what's going on? Are you having those conversations privately? Because we're not hearing a lot publicly.
Well, there's not a whole lot of conversation happening at all. The president of the United States is the most powerful person in the country. His responsibility is to bring the country together, not just around times of tragedy, but to help us make progress, to make the government work again. And it's so dysfunctional right now. I'll tell you, I can't even count the number of Republicans I met at the vigil last night who were saying, Congressman Ryan, please do something. Please get this done. Please talk to your Republican friends. To help get this done. The Republicans on the streets of America want this done, but Mitch McConnell and the Republicans in the Senate are in the pocket of the NRA, and Americans need to make it so visibly uncomfortable for them over the course of the next few weeks that they have to do something, because quite frankly, they're completely out of step. And this conversation needs to be started by the president. He can't be tying it to immigration reform or any other red herring that he wants to throw into the mix here. He needs to get his act together, too, and help lead this country.
Do you think there's a chance that the president will say this morning, I want to see the Senate come back?
For the president to say that?
Do you think he could?
I don't know. I don't know if the president will say that. The president is not a leader. He just isn't. He's a divider. And I hope he does. But all indications now of just focusing this on mental health, on focusing this on immigration, tells me he wants to continue to like slow walk this issue. He hopes it goes away. And I'm telling him directly to you, Donald Trump, this issue is not going away. And I'm telling Mitch McConnell, this issue is not going away. We're going to mobilize the American people around this issue. We're sick of this dysfunctional government, not just on gun control, but on health care, on education, on debt, on income inequality. Across the board, this government has been a complete failure to the forgotten people in Dayton and Youngstown and Gary, Indiana, and all of these other places across the United States of America. It's time to mobilize against this intractable government that won't do a damn thing for the American people. The only thing they passed was tax cuts. This guy's been in 2 years plus. All we got is tax cuts for rich people? I mean, come on.
Congressman, you tweeted, white nationalism is the biggest domestic threat to the U.S. We have not heard those words from the president, as you know. Yet you told Jake Tapper yesterday that you cannot not tie the president's rhetoric to what happened behind me here in El Paso, to the manifesto, which you read, I read as well. Do you believe the president is responsible?
I think the president has to bear some responsibility for creating a culture in the United States around race baiting, around demonizing people of color, around demonizing immigrants. I mean, when you read that manifesto, it looked like it could have been written by a Trump speechwriter. I mean, let's be honest with each other. And look, I'm the most bipartisan guy you ever met. The guys I drink beer and watch football with, they're all Republicans. I got a lot of Republican friends. This is so far beyond left and right, it's not even funny. This is about racism. This is about demonizing people of color. And then the lowest common denominator in our society, they get in a car and they drive 10 hours to go kill people of color, to go kill Mexicans, in this kid's words. I mean, this is the environment that the president has created. He's made it okay. And when you have David Duke and white supremacists campaigning for you and saying things like, this guy's really gonna implement our agenda, and then the president literally does things like that and says things like that and provides political cover. Look, more than anything, the president of the United States is a cultural figure. And that cultural figure can either mobilize the country to say, hey, let's go to the moon, let's reach for the stars like President Kennedy did, or that cultural figure can say, hey, let's tell people of color to go back to the shithole countries that they came from. And that's what you're getting from this president. And so I'm not optimistic that he's gonna all of a sudden be able to be a leader in the United States of America. I'm completely concerned that he's not. I think he's gonna try to slow walk it. And I just want I just want every American to think about what's happened in America in the last 24 hours, 36 hours, and the president ties the issue that would help fix that to immigration reform. That's a joke.
Representative Tim Ryan, we appreciate you taking the time for us this morning. Thank you.
Thank you.